Hey guys, welcome back to Farming Simulator 17 with me, Brad M73. Picking up from where we left off before, let's see here. I think I need to... do some course play stuff here. Let's go ahead and get this guy started. I think he's just gonna drive the course. Tab around, kind of take a quick look at what's going on over here, and I think I can go ahead and hire. Oh no, I cannot. And it's still not working. Okay, there's that. This guy, okay. If I hire, it's still not. For some reason, always like does this gap right here, and it does that. So we'll have to come back and pick that up. It's not that big of a deal. I think we have all of the. Let's see what do we got. Everything's harvested. Actually, wait, not everything. Whoops. Have I forgotten how to play this? It's been a couple days since I've played Farming Sim. I have been getting these massive migraines lately, which have just been driving me absolutely insane. And it was kind of to the point in the last couple days where I couldn't even see. So I had to, I just had to kind of take an anti-inflammatory and lay down for a while. So today's been fine though. Haven't had any problems yet today. I don't know if it was like a change in the weather or if I was just feeling stressed out or what it was. But I was kind of hoping to kind of get back to recording earlier this week, but I just didn't do it. And it's kind of like I think this time of year when it's like cold and dark and dreary and compounded with other problems that have kept me from getting regular sleep. I just have kind of been in this mood for the last few weeks where I just constantly feel tired, and I'm it's like I need to get energized. I need to do something to kind of keep me in the filled with energy and goodness and happiness, I guess. So yeah, there's always that. So yeah, I'm back. Hopefully I'm going to try to kind of get back to my regular schedule, doing several episodes of Farming Sim a week. I'm not exactly sure about when I'm going to be resuming live streaming. I may do some live streaming this coming weekend or maybe before the end of the week. I just don't really know yet. Live streaming was like never really my major thing. But I do enjoy it, and I have actually enjoyed it for the past few months that I've been doing it. So I might actually try to do some more live streaming later this week. I think today's Tuesday, January 10th of 2017, and so I might try to do some tomorrow on the 11th. I don't know. We'll just have to wait and see if I'm in the mood. I really have to kind of be in the mood for that kind of stuff. Because otherwise, it tends to just feel like a job, and I don't want my YouTubing to feel like, it's a job. I want to do it because it's fun, and I have fun doing it. I also ran into like an issue a couple weeks back with my Mac where it was acting like the hard drive is almost full, and it was. I only had like 3 gigabytes left out of a 3 terabyte drive, or no, 300 gigabytes left out of 3 terabyte drive, which is not much. It was actually slightly less than like 10% of the drive was full or remaining. And it was kind of scary. Okay, so this planted here. I think the next thing I need to do, use the cultivator, or no, the not the cultivator, the plow. So we got to get all that done this episode. We probably aren't going to get much else done, but I need to get that going as soon as I can. If I, there we go. Come on. Yeah, we really need to get the plow. Oh, plow's over here. And I can't really remember if this tractor's even big enough for it. I might end up having to put it on the Massey, you know, the big Massey Ferguson we bought. I might end up having to use that one, but I at least need to get it started with something, so at least we're getting some work done. So that's what I'm doing right now. And there we go. I think what I actually might do, hold on, let's fire you really quick. No, just disconnect. Maybe I'll trade, because these do a little bit better with the plows. So I think maybe that's what I'll do. Yeah, I think that's... Let's just drive him over. We'll get him working on this, and we'll get back to plowing with the case instead. I think that'll work a little bit better. Let's see. Okay, hire. Here we are. Where did our? There we go. Oh my gosh. Get into. I tab to a tractor that's already started, and I turn it off. Nope, leave it down. Now I can flip it over. Right, and off we go. So we're getting a nice big swath there. Okay, let's see. Okay, we're doing... What is this? Oh, soybeans. Where is my truck? And... Oh, I guess I didn't manually select. That's what the problem was. I don't think I manually selected the combine. And because the stopping point... Or the course play route wasn't actually out into the field, but off to the side, it won't automatically detect this sugar beet harvester. So I think that's what the actual problem was. But thankfully, we're almost done harvesting sugar beets, so we don't have too much left to do. Let's see, we've got pickup trucks up there. Oh yeah, we were kind of using the pickup truck to sell some trees, and I think from the last episode. I think I actually delved very briefly into actually doing some forestry work. But as you can see, it doesn't really do too much to pay off, especially in hard mode. So I guess if you really wanted to make hard mode into really super hard mode, then, you know, just do trees all the time. But I don't think it really works as well for a Let's Play series, just because we make so little money. Now, down the line sometime, maybe a few months down the road, when we've got a lot more money, I will plan on buying a Ponzi Scorpion and a Ponzi Buffalo. That way, you know, we can do much larger loads of wood and we can see what wood chipping is all about and all that kind of stuff. I have played around with a little bit, kind of off screen in my own time. And again, just like they've really nerfed the wood in this version of Farming Sim. It's just, it's not quite as fun. It's fun to use. It's just, you know, for building a farm and trying to get money, especially off the start, doesn't really work that well. At least, you know, compared to the last, you know, to Farming Simulator 15, where it went, you know, was really good. So I think they kind of maybe wanted to get back to just Farming Simulator and not necessarily Tree Farming Simulator, but, you know, that's a speculation on my part. I still haven't heard any news as far as, you know, any new DLCs or anything like that actually being put out by Giants. I mean, there's tons of mods coming out, and it looks like they're primarily, you know, supporting mods right now. You know, getting them into their mod hub and making sure the mods are running well, which I haven't had. I don't think I've had any problems with any of the, you know, the mods that are on the official mod hub in game, which is good. You know, if, usually when you have issues like that with mods, you know, then you're not very happy. At least I'm not. I get pretty cranky. All right, let's pick this up. We'll just drive this down to the bottom of field 23. We'll get him raking away. Well, not really raking. Weeding away, I guess. Here we are. Let's see how we are doing. Could it be? Could it be that we are finished harvesting sugar beets? I think it might be. It's tab to the bat. Well, actually, I can't go. I'm gonna see like how many more. We got 456. I want to pick up all the rest of these sugar beets. Probably not really worth just picking up these few, but hey. I don't think there are any more up. Oh, there might have been a few. It's out of my way. All right. There's a decent amount right there, and then we should have just a few bits here. That's not bad. I mean, we got, what, an extra, like, 5% so far? I think we were at 90% when we started this, right? Maybe 96%. All right. All right. So what I'm going to do, I will just bring this guy over to offload the sugar beets. And then I'll just have him go run a course play route, and then we'll disconnect the sugar beet harvester and then we'll move the big tractor over to do the actual plowing. How are we doing down here? Uh-oh. We are full again. Okay. Drive course, and then just drive now, and he's automatically going to go and drive the course. We can jump up here and We'll bring the pipe, fold the pipe in, and then we'll fold this harvester by hitting X. No? Now there's B. I get. Okay, I guess it is folded up. Okay, well, never mind. I thought, like, the top folded down or something, but I don't have any folding controls or anything like that, unless it's... No? Change tool select. Yeah, it's just G. Yep. Looks like, there's nothing to do here. Ah. Now we'll turn this guy around. Here is, okay, coming up that way. We'll just kind of position this guy right here. That way we'll just be able to run out. Ah, well, let's see here. No. There. No. Yeah, we'll flip this around. And then we'll just hire him, go back to the course play tractor. And now I'm just gonna take this guy off of course play. We're gonna remove the course, we won't need it. And then we'll drive down, offload that combine now that we have a empty trailer here. So yeah, we're kind of all through the holidays, you know, season. Kids are going back to school now, which I know they probably all hate. No more video games, right? And it's cold. I mean, it's been, we had like really, I mean, it was like 3 degrees a few nights ago. And then I think tomorrow it's going to be almost 60 degrees. I mean, it's been like super weird. Temperatures here in the United States. And of course I'm speaking in Fahrenheit, so if you're wondering what those temperatures are in Celsius, just ask Google. Google can tell you. Google can do the conversion better than I can. I think 3 degrees Celsius is about minus 15 or 16, and then 60 degrees Celsius is about 15, no, 60 degrees Fahrenheit is about 15 Celsius or so. Okay, let's move forward that. Actually, I will turn him around. And let's choose the combine here. So we'll just finish off the rest of the field. We'll be done. And then everything else will just be plowing, which it doesn't really seem like we've done that much so far this episode. So plowing is going to get kind of boring. But pretty soon, especially as we buy larger tractors, I'm gonna have to invest in some larger plows. I mean, there's just, I gotta do it. And we may not need, well, let's see. I think we have two harvest cycles until we have to do the two upper fields there. I think we plowed that before this field. What I want to do, though, is to get the plowing cycles of all the fields together, you know, all at the same time. So I may forego plowing this big field here in order to do it later. And it might be a more efficient use of our time and our money, because we're not going to lose like a huge, you know, we're only going to lose 10% of the crop, which isn't that much. I mean, it's a, you know, it's enough. It's a lot. It's not insignificant, but it's not terrible either. Here, I mean, the other option I would have would be to just harvest it off screen. Or not harvest, plow. Golly, I'm getting all my words mixed up. I'm getting my words mixed up, and I hate that. I'm telling you guys, it's like lack of sleep. That's what it does to you. There we go. Uh-oh. He done? Oh, good. Let's see. B. So we are going to plow across the field now. Uh-oh. There we go. Got to pay attention to make sure we get every bit plowed. I mean, it's not going to be thousands of dollars if we don't. But I'm just kind of a perfectionist when it comes to that kind of stuff. So yeah, we also need a new tipper. And we do need new tractors. I mean, we just need new everything. You know, and aside from doing like one big field job of something, kind of, you know, stuck planting crops. Kind of the way it goes. Alright, so while we're plowing, let's see, let's take a quick look. Yeah, I think canola is what I'm going to plant next. We've got it, you know, we're going to have plenty. We'll probably have close to, let's see, 90,000. Not quite 90,000, probably like 86 or... What? See, here we go. Here we go. It's doing that thing again. Nope, you're fired. Doing that thing where it's wanting to turn around. I don't know why. I can't figure that out. Okay, so I've rehired the worker. Don't know why it's doing that. So yeah, we're going to be planting pretty much canola. I think corn and then canola on everything else. So, let's see here. Okay, we've got this. Go ahead and just turn him around. On the train tracks. Yes. Blocked by... Oh. I thought he would be able to get right around that, but I guess not. There we go. All right, let's let's take this back. See how much soybeans we're gonna have. And I think we can only have a maximum of 100,000 in each silo. So I just think, you know, for this next round, I'm thinking that canola, you know, we'll be able to do like a nice big canola harvest. And get that, you know, get all that going. And then what about pigs? I've got 87, so we still have quite a ways to go to get to that magical 100, which will probably be the day after today, before we can start selling pigs. And once we do start selling pigs, I think we're going to have, you know, some really, you know, we are going to have a nice, you know, bit of money start to roll in with those. So I am really super looking forward to that. That's going to be happening very soon. Yeah. Back up here. And we got a decent amount of seed and everything. So, let's see. I'm going to hit the Y button. So we get to the canola right there. And I'll just start out right up here, planting canola. And these fields, again, you know, they don't need any... They do need to be weeded. I didn't realize we hadn't weeded those yet. Ahead and weed these out. All right, let's get him up. Get him in front of that seeder so we can get the seeds going. We want to make good use of our time here. And I guess we'll just pull in over here. I love these old New Holland tractors. I just like the old, you know, not old. I mean, well, they're probably old to a lot of you guys, young to some others, and about as old as me to other to other tractors. Ah, no, get in. There we go. But I do kind of like, you know, those 80s era tractors. I don't know what it is, like 70, like late 70s, early 80s, and then kind of in the end of the 90s, they started, you know, getting kind of cheap, or cheaply made, I think. And of course, compared to what they have now, the, you know, people will be like, oh man, if we could only go back to the 80s when the track, you know, it's all, I guess, comparative. All right, so we should be good to go now. You can see this tractor's really not having it. But, uh-oh. Can I get it over to the right a little bit more? Here we go. And he'll be much faster on the way back down, I promise. Okay, so let's just take this up to one of the shelters. We're going to kind of get it out of the way and park it for right now. And then we'll kind of look at, you know, what type of jobs I might want to do to earn some additional money. as we really need the money. Oh, and I forgot to look and see how much we currently have on our loan. I think it's pretty much close to being maxed out, if it's not maxed out. So yeah, we really need to really start concentrating on building wealth again. Okay. And we'll just back him in here, no big deal. Pull him out just a little bit, that way I can... No. There. That way I can get out. alright. Loans. Yeah, $180,000. So we've only got $20,000 that we can even play around with, and there's really nothing that I need to buy right now for that amount. Let's see. I want to kind of look at some of these smaller fields, get some of these smaller missions. At least, you know, we can get them done. You know, they're not going to make us rich by any stretch. But when we knock, you know, a few out at a time, get a little bit of extra money, doesn't hurt anything. We also get the, you know, the notoriety with the different farmers, so that when we finally get to the point where we want to buy these fields, you know, they're going to be like, oh, they're going to give us the best price. Which is pretty good. That's why it's kind of good to do these missions when you're in single player. Uh-oh. Need to raise these up above the crops. There we go. All right. You don't have to. It doesn't matter. It's just cosmetic as far as like where you have these raised. But it's still pretty cool. I love the look of the, you know, the color of these Amazon tractors, or the, not the tractors, but the equipment, the nice greens, the bright oranges. It just, I don't know, has like an inviting farm feeling to me for some reason. And it is very difficult to spray when you can't really see where you're supposed to be spraying. Even from the top down, it's really difficult to see. You just kind of have to pick a point on the other side of the field and just try to drive, you know, straight towards that point. Probably a little bit easier to do from in the cab, but... Yeah, here's an old Hurleyman tractor. Again, I just love these old... I love the styling of these old tractors. I don't know why. It's just, I think they're inherently cool. Alright, so again, we'll just kind of pick a point down the field. And we're just going to try to drive towards that point. Let's get a slightly better view here. There we go. Map back up a little bit. Kind of see how our cedars are doing. The plow's still down there. Plowing field 24. I'm kind of just like, I don't know if I want to continue plowing this episode or, you know, leave that field and, you know, until the next time we actually have to plow all the fields. In some ways, I think that makes a little bit more sense, but, and then in others, I'm like, I'm not so sure. Come on, get the field done. I feel as though I've missed a spot. There we go. So another $2,000 right there. That'll kind of help things out. Oh yeah, and we want to use the the weeder on field 15 before we start to plant there as well. So, the case isn't doing too bad over there. He's doing all right. But, when we go to buy a new tractor, let's look at the case really quick here. Let's find it. Now, this is a 145 horsepower tractor. And so I want to make sure, whoops. I want to make sure that the new tractor that I buy to replace the case, and actually, where's the New Holland? The New Holland's only 125 horsepower. I want to make sure that whatever tractor I buy is a higher horsepower than either of those. So, what was it? 145. So yeah, there's 110 now with the I think with the upgrades you can get it up to 138. Actually, that's a cool little tractor too. I mean, that would be useful for certain jobs. And we're looking at the T6, that's 143. With only two of those, we can get that up to 163. That's only 127,000. And we can get a front loader for it, which is good. We can just leave the wheel standard. So 130,000 there. We can go with a Valtra. This is kind of a newer tractor, so we can get the front loader attacher for that. And then we can get up to, for 140,000, we can get up to 185 horsepower, which would, might even be better investment for the money. And then what else? Got the same 166, 193 for 150 thousand, 151,000. And then now we're up to the 700 Vario. Now we're getting pretty expensive. Got the 16, the 20, and the 24, and yeah, we're up to 202,000. So this would be a really good step, though. If we could kind of hold off until we can afford 200,000, yeah, that would be pretty good, I think. Ouch! And we just got $2,000 wage payment there. So there goes that money. How are we? Okay, he's not doing anything over here. And he's still just plowing along. Having a good old time, I guess. Let's see. How much time do we have left? Oh, we've only got about, well, we got about 20 minutes left, I think. Let's see. What's going on down here? Probably not too much. What about field 8? Harvest job. Ooh, yeah, let's do that. Oh, no. Yeah, let's do this. This one, let's see. Oh, it's not going to take that much longer. Let's just go ahead and do this mission. We'll kind of close the episode out with this. I'm not going to do a time lapse or anything like that, but we'll just kind of close this out. We'll get a nice chunk of change. Pay down the debt a little bit. I first need to lower the head. Come on now, turn her on. There we go. Actually, I just want to go. I want to go this way. Kind of want to go around in a circle. Even though I'm not always convinced by myself that that's like the best course of action. I just always do. So I've been playing some games. I finally kind of figured out how to play Transport Fever, so I've been playing that kind of over this Christmas and holiday break. And I've also got into playing a ton of Grand Theft Auto online, GTA Online. So if you guys play GTA Online and you're ever, you ever want to hit me up and see if you can play with me. That's probably the best place. that you're going to be able to find me to actually, you know, get in game with me. I'm BradM73 on the Rockstar Social Club. Send me a friend invite and do some heists or something. It'll be fun. But I've been doing that. I'm trying to think what else I've been playing. I've been playing some, you know, other little games here and there. I didn't really pick up a whole lot during the Steam the Christmas sale. Matter of fact, I can't really think of anything major that I did buy. I was playing a lot of Mount and Blade. You guys are not familiar with Mount and Blade. It sounds like mountain, like climb the mountain, but no, it's like mount, like you mount a horse. Mount and Blade, which is, you know, kind of like cavalry and swords in a way. The old Mount and Blade Warband, which I think came out in like 2011. And I've always, for the last couple years, I'd heard about the game, and I'm like, oh, I'm going to give this a try, because it was only like, I don't know, it was like dirt cheap, whatever the price was. And I'm like, this is an awesome game. It actually is a really good game. Even to today's standards, there's games that come out that could not keep me captivated for as long as Mountain Blade has. And I haven't played it in like several days now because of the headaches and everything, but... I might, you know, kind of play that a little bit more. Probably not going to do any series on it or anything like that, or live streams, just because of the age of the game. I don't think anybody really wants to watch me sit around and play Mountain Blade Warband. However, there is a new Mountain Blade game coming out, possibly this year, called Mount and Blade Bannerlord, and I definitely have my eye on it. It looks really good. You know, another, you know, predecessor to the awesome Mountain Blade game. So yeah, I'm definitely going to be keeping an eye on that. Hopefully keeping my fingers crossed that it'll be out sooner than later. I also discovered the BattleTech real-time strategy game that was apparently on Kickstarter like over a year ago. Somehow it completely flew past me, but I noticed that you could become a late backer, which I did at the highest level that I could. So I've always been a huge BattleTech fan. I have like every BattleTech game ever made, from, you know, the original BattleTech, the Crescent Hawks Inception, the BattleTech 2, the Crescent Hawks Revenge. I have the original Mech Warrior. Which was more of like a mech simulator. And I have Mech Warrior 2, 3, 4. I'm trying to think of what else. I had Mech Commander, which was like another... That was actually like a real-time strategy game that came out, 17... I think it was around 2000, 2001, I want to say. It was a long time ago. I was just... I used to love just the story that was created around the BattleTech role-playing game. This is a tabletop role-playing game. I've got a box full of, you know, lead miniatures in the closet somewhere. And actually, it was really cool. They used to be made here in Cincinnati by a company called Ral Partha, which I think was... I think they kind of went out of business. I believe their assets may have been purchased by another company some years back, but... when I was a kid, I used to go down and actually go into the factory. They would let us come back and look at the different figures and just, you know, buy a few of them. It was awesome. I used to love doing that. Buying direct from the manufacturer in cash. It was like hush hush under the table. Nah, not really. And then, and you know, it was kind of a funny story. Like, I went down there one time, and another one of my, like, one of my friends went with me, and who kind of played BattleTech with us. But I, you know, I was going down because I, you know, saved up some money. I wanted to buy some, you know, miniatures, and they weren't cheap. I mean, these things, little things, could be like $20 for like a little tiny piece of lead, and. So anyway, one of my friends decided, yeah, he was going to go down with me, and ended up shop, like, he, like, put one into his pocket and got caught. And needless to say, that was the last time I was ever allowed to go back into the warehouse and actually look through all the different, you know, models that they had. Because they actually had a lot of stuff that, you know, they weren't doing current production runs, but they still had stock of. So, like, I, you know, like, if there was a mech that, that I wanted that they didn't have in the stores, you know, I could be like, hey, could you, you know, I could call them up and say, hey, can you pour one of these for me or two of these for me? And I'll be down later and pick them up. And they would, you know, they'd pour the, you know, they'd get out the molds and pour me a few mechs. And by the time I'd get there, sometimes they'd still be a little bit warm. Nah, usually they were, you know, they were cold to the touch or cool to the touch, but they just got them out of the, you know, the mold, and they were still a little bit warm, because it's molten lead, and that's probably why I am, though. I'm insane, you know, the way I am today, because of all that lead that I played with as a teen. Nah, not really, but I you know, I love the universe of BattleTech and the stories that were created to kind of support the universe, and I kind of grew up in my teenage years with that, and all, you know, just even later in years with the computer games, so it was pretty cool. So anyway, there's a company, they acquired the rights, and they're doing like a turn-based strategy game, you know, based on, you know, the modern BattleTech, I guess, and it looks really good. It looks really, really good. And I'm hoping that there's the beta comes out sometime. It's supposed to come out over the winter. I think that it's supposed to be first quarter of 2017. So this month, you know, sometime between now and the end of March. And I actually will do a series on that. I'll probably do, I might even do Let's Plays on that. You know, like, not Let's Plays, live streams. You know, I might actually do live streams on that. That's how much I love BattleTech. I would actually do a live stream on it. So, yeah. By the time I get this done, I'm sure everybody's going to be done. Let's see, wait a second. Oh, I can't open up the map. Oh, wait. No. Oh, there we go. Yep, everybody's done. The plowing on field 24 is finished, and the weeding on 15 looks finished, as well as the seeding on 14. So we'll come back in the next episode. We'll pretty much just do, you know, knock out 15, 19, 24 really quick, and then we'll be able to fast forward time and kind of go on. And we'll see how long. I think we're coming up to, I think we got about 10 minutes left or so right now. So we should be done with this in just a few minutes. Come on, get her into gear. There we go. Whoops. So we're about 2/3 of the way finished now with this field. So yeah, we've only got like 4 more minutes to go here. We'll see what we can get done in 6 minutes or so. How's that sound? Also, if there's any new games that you want to see me play this that are coming out this year, or maybe that have come out recently, you know, don't forget to let me know in the comments, because I always like hearing, you know, your guys' opinions of what you'd like to see me playing. You know, and I'm always looking for something new to kind of play and try out. One game that I was just sent by Playway, it's called Camper Jumper Simulator, and it's definitely not a simulator. It's kind of like Goat Simulator, except you're just driving a camper around, and it's kind of just a lot of nonsense. It's only like a $2 game. It actually just came out on Steam, I think, last week. And I was just like, you gotta be kidding me. Like, this isn't actually a thing, right? And it is. It's a thing. It's a game. And so I might actually do like a short Let's Play on that. Not a Let's Play, a live stream. I keep saying Let's Play instead of live stream tonight. I don't know why. but yeah, I kind of want to do one of that just so that I can say that, okay, I did it and now I can uninstall it, kind of a thing. Yeah, it's not like super great, but you know, for $2, it's a fun distraction, I guess. Like if it was $10, I'd be like, yeah, no, don't even dream of spending money on it. But for $2, it's kind of like one of those impulse buy things. Right. 71%. Come on. Give me more percents. I need more percentage. It seems like the closer you get to the field being finished with the harvest, like the less the percentage changes. Only when doing these jobs though, when you're just normally, you know, harvesting. Well, when you normally harvest a field, you don't actually get these percentages, I guess. And I guess I'll just go around the other way, counterclockwise, for a little while. How's that? Oh, do, do, do. Come on, go. 73%. Now, I'm pretty sure that the little round icon at the top is... Oh, wait, that's this fill level. So that really doesn't have anything to do with it. To do with the actual how much... See, I'm looking at the fill level down here, 74%. But I'm looking at the completion circle up here, which is way more than 74%. I was like, what? But yeah, I think it has been about a week since I played Farming Simulator. I just kind of had to take a break from it, and it was like super freezing cold last week. You know, as some of you guys know, I have a neighbor who literally drives me insane. And keeps me sleep deprived sometimes. And yes, I've been moving, you know, I've been looking for a place to move to. However, you know, it's not like I rent. It's like when you own a place, you know, you can't just like pack up and tell your landlord, well, I'm going to be leaving at the end of the week or at the end of the month. You know, you have to actually do bank stuff, and it's a long and involved and very complicated process. So if I move, it's like I better, you know, I gotta be darn sure I got my, you know, my finances in check and my, you know, ducks in a row and all that kind of stuff. Because if I make a serious offer, you know, then I gotta make sure that I can get the offer through to purchase this house, and then get moved and then sell my old place as quickly as I can, so, or have another buyer lined up for my place. So it's just like, it's one of those stressful things that it's so inconvenient for me to move, it's like not even funny. But at the same time, I am literally like kind of going insane because of, you know, sleep deprivation, and it's just cold, and you know, you guys know I wasn't looking forward to the winter time. As it is, but you know, you just kind of do what you got to do. All right, let's tab back over. Let's see here. We got to get a little bit more. Always kind of forgets this little corner of the field right here. I don't know why, but it does. Let's. Actually, wait a second. Where is... There he is. Let's have this guy do the rest of the seeding. much time do we have now? Oh no, we only got a few minutes. So yeah, I do think I'm going to wait off on field 23. Oh, that's a big field, though.
I don't know what I want to do. What do I want to do, you guys?
I don't know. Maybe let me know in the comments. Should I plow field 23 or should I wait? Let me know in the comments what I should do. And I'll wait to record another episode until you guys let me know. Because that's only fair to you guys. Gotta keep you guys in the loop. That's how this works. That's how this old YouTube gaming thing works, you guys. Alright. So... go. So yeah, in the meantime, we're gonna finish seeding this field with canola. Yeah, canola. Where's the oh, I was looking for the plow. So I think the next plow up from this is the blue lemkin, is if I'm not mistaken. Whoops. Take a quick look at that before we go. Cultivators, plows. Yeah, this is what we have right now, the Amazon Cayron. Then we've got the lemkin as a step up from that, which this is probably what I'm going to have to buy next. And then we've got the Salford. And I don't have anything really right now that could, you know, pull it. The Massey Ferguson would pull it, but... I don't think it's really great at it, but you know, it's like it gets the job done, I guess. I guess I could say that. All right, well, thanks again for stopping by, hanging out with me in Farming Simulator 17. I promise I'm gonna be back with more episodes very soon. So again, do not forget to hit the like. Hit that like button and please subscribe if you haven't done so already. And we will see you back for more. I am Bradham73. Bye for now.